فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
If he narrates it with the form of Sighat al-Tamrid, such as what? Ruwiya, aba yurwa, dhukira, o yudhkar, hukiya, o yuhka. He narrates in any of those forms, this hadith is not authentic. Who is it not authentic to? Him. It's not authentic to him. That's why he used the word ruwiya, dhukira, yurwa, yudhkaru, yuhka. He used that because of what? Because it's not authentic to him. It may be authentic to other ulama. Does that make sense? That's now where the hadith of Hisham ibn Ammar comes in. Huh? Where Bukhari narrated it with the word qala. Qala is what? Sighatu ish? Sighatul jazm. Sighatul jazm in Bukhari, huh, is what? It's mu'allaq. If you wish, you want to say that. Even though Bukhari did, can you say it's mu'allaq? The hadith of Hisham al-Ammar. No. Remember we said mu'allaq means when the Bukhari drops his teacher off, right?
Oh yeah, he never dropped
his teacher. Hisham ibn Ammar is his teacher. But even if we say that he did drop a teacher out of there, he narrated with an. So either way, you're no way able to go out of it. Amazing. First of all, Hisham ibn Ammar is his teacher. So the hadith is not mu'allaq aslan. The second is, even if we say that it is Bukhari did drop his teacher off, we do say that, we accept it.
Yeah.
Are you with me?
Yeah.
He narrated it with an, and an is sighatul jazm.
Yeah.
So it's sahih to Bukhari.
Yeah.
The hadith is what then?
Sahih.
Sahih. Ish mushkila.
Yeah.
What's the problem then?
Okay.
So that's something you need to know. We've now learned that. We're now going to learn after Bukhari and Muslim, which are the most authentic books? In order. We're going to look, we've looked at it previously, huh? The levels of Sahih. Are you with me?
Mm-hmm.
We previously looked at the Maratib al-Sihah, the Maratib al-Sahih, bin nisbati li rijali isladihi, in accordance to the men that narrated, which we called it Asahul Asanid. Remember? The most authentic chains of narration. We spoke about that one. That was the first type. Now we're going to talk about it. بالنسبة للكتب المروي فيها ذلك الحديث, the books in which it's narrated in. The first one is, brothers, pay attention, the hadith which is the hadith which is the highest in authenticity is that which Bukhari and Muslim both agree upon. The hadith which is متفق عليه أما رواه البخاري ومسلم is the most authentic book. Authentic what? Hadith. That is the most authentic what? Hadith. What comes after that? The hadith narrated by Bukhari. He's singular on. Are you with me? The third one is that which Muslim is alone on. The fourth one is what? The hadith which are of the conditions of Bukhari and Muslim, which they haven't narrated in the Sahih. That's the fourth one. The fifth one is that which is of the condition of Bukhari, which he hasn't narrated in his book. Sixth is that which is the condition of Imam Muslim, which he hasn't narrated in his book. Seven is Ibn Khuzaymah, his book. 8. Are you with me? Sorry. Ibn Hibban takes precedence over Ibn Khuzaymah's book. And then who comes next? Ibn Hibban. And then Ibn Khuzaymah comes. Who is the teacher and who is the student? Ibn Hibban is the student of Ibn Khuzaymah. Whose book went first? Why did the student go before his teacher? Yeah, he's better than his teacher. Plus he finished his book. Sorry, what did you say? Whose condition is better? Ibn Hibban is not better in terms of the conditions. Now Ibn Hibban is not better than his teacher Ibn Khuzaymah in terms of the conditions. Lakin he is better in the terms where he finishes book. The fact that he finishes book, the scholars, they put it first. He's got a complete book. How did the scholars know the condition of Bukhari Muslims? Who told them? Where did they get it from? Bukhari Muslim, who knows their conditions? How? The conditions of Bukhari and Muslim, they did not mention their conditions. They didn't say, this is our condition, this is our condition, this is what we're going to do, this is how we're going to do it. Are you with me? Mm-hmm. How was it found out? It was found out by the Bahithin, the people who researched after them. تَتَبْعُ وَالِاسْتِقْرَاءِ They followed up the book. They looked how the book works, where it goes, where is it heading, where is it at. They saw it. So then they gave it, they said, this is the condition of the scholar, this is his condition here. Some got it right, some didn't get it right. Some got questioned for their points, and some didn't. Okay? The best thing that was said regarding the condition of Bukhari Muslim is as follows. This is their conditions, both of them. أَن يَكُونَ الْحَدِيثُ مَرْوِيًّا That the hadith is narrated من طريق رجال من رجال الكتابين That the book is narrated from the men of those two books. They have men. The men in which they have narrated on, no one is allowed to bring another man and introduce it and say, this is the condition of Bukhari and Muslim. If that man was not used by Bukhari, you try to use it in your mustadrak and say, this is the condition of Bukhari or Muslim. The question is, his brother, this individual Bukhari didn't use, nor did Muslim use this man. Are you with me? For example, Abu Zubayr al-Makki, Bukhari did not use him. Muslim used him. Are you with me? Are you with me? When you say, don't say ala shart al-shaykhain, the question is, Abu Zubayr al-Makki was not used by Bukhari. This man is not used by Bukhari. Are you with me? The second thing is, or ahadihim, or one of them uses them. So you can say that this is the condition of Muslim. The second one is, you have to observe the way in which Bukhari and Muslim observe those narrators. For example, Hushaym ibn Bashir, you guys with me? Who is he? He is from the students of Muhammad ibn Shihab al-Zuhri. Are you with me? Bukhari used Hushaym ibn Bashir. Bukhari, what did he do? He used him. And so did he. Who did he also use? Bukhari. Bukhari also used Ibn Shihab al-Zuhri. If you go to Bukhari, you'll find Hushaym ibn Bashir. He's from Rijal al-Bukhari. He's from the men of Bukhari. And also what? And you also find... he used Muhammad ibn Shihab al-Zuhri. Both of them are the men of Bukhari Muslim. Good. Somebody narrates a hadith from Hushaym ibn Bashir, and hadith that Hushaym ibn Bashir narrated from his teacher, Ibn Shihab al-Zuhri. Is that hadith authentic? Is that hadith condition of Bukhari? Yeah? Hey, Saad? Saad, you with me? Bukhari, rahimahullah, if we go to Hushaym ibn Bashir, pay attention. Hushaym ibn Bashir. Pay attention. Hushaym ibn Bashir, is he min rijal al-Bukhari? Is he from the men of Bukhari? The answer is yes. Bukhari, did he use him?
No.
Good. What about Muhammad ibn Shihab al-Zuhri? Min rijal al-Bukhari. Bukhari did use him. If Hushaym ibn Bashir narrates from Bukhari, ibn Shihab al-Zuhri, is the hadith accepted? Is it from? Can we say this is from the hadith of Bukhari? Huh?
Yeah, of course.
Huh? No, it's not, it's weak. You see, Bukhari never did any book. See, this is now why the scholars would say you have to look at how they use the men. Hushaym al-Bashir, when he narrates from Muhammad ibn Shahab, he's weak. But if he narrates from other narrators, he's not weak. You know why? Because Hushaym al-Bashir narrated this hadith from Muhammad ibn Shahab on a day when it was very windy. Pay attention. And so he wrote these hadith all in his books. And it was a windy day, so he lost all the papers he wrote on, and where he wrote it on, and it flew out of his hand. So later when he went back, he tried to narrate it from where? Exactly. And he was getting it wrong. So he was weak. Hakim al-Naythaburi, in his Mustadrak, he will say that Hushaym narrated hadith from Ibn Shahab al-Zuhri, and he will say this is from the conditions of who? Does that make sense? So that's the definition that Ibn Hajar rahimahullah chose, and that's the correct one. You with me? Has to be observed like that. Inshallah, we're going to talk about in this set, بإذن الله الكريم, الحسن لذاتي. Ibn Hajar says, rahimahullah, فإن خف الضبط فالحسن لذاته. He says, فإن خف, if it becomes less, it deducts, it reduces. الضبط, ضبط is what? The memory. We spoke about the five conditions that make a hadith sahih. From one of them was what? Al-dabt. Dabt is memory. And we remember we spoke about the dabt is how many types? Al-dabdu, dabdani. The dabt is how many?
Two
types. Or as Yahya ibn Ma'in said, al-thabtu thabtani. So thabtu al-hifd. And the second was thabtu al-sadr. The memory of the brain and the memory of the... So here what happens is the hasanu lidati, it has all the other conditions that sahih has, but what does it have with it? Huh? It's just that the memory is slightly low. So here it brings us to what does it mean linguistically, the word hasan? Linguistically, the word hasan, first of all, is a sifatu mushabbaha min al-husni. Husni in Arabic is meant by beauty. Bima'an al-jamali, it's beauty. Beauty. And technically, there's an ikhtilaf regarding the scholars in defining the word Hasan. The defining of the word Hasan, there is a lot of khilaf that came between the scholars. And it's a stage between Sahih and Da'if. The definitions that some of the scholars gave were not Jami'un Mani'a. From the scholars that gave the ta'rif to it is Imam Al-Khattabi Rahimahullah. And Imam Al-Khattabi Rahimahullah, he defined it to be what? هو ما عرف مخرجه. It is something that it's known where it comes out from. واشتهر رجاله, and its men are famous. وعليه مدار أكثر الحديث, and it's what the majority of the hadith revolve around. وهو الذي يقبله أكثر العلماء, and it is what the majority of the scholars have accepted. ويستعمله عامة الفقهاء, and the general فقهاء also use. That's his definition. We're going to talk about how weak that definition of his is. Also, Tirmidhi, rahimahullah, he defined it as what? كُلُّ حَدِيثٌ يُرْوَى. It is every hadith that is narrated. لَا يَكُونُ فِي إِسْلَادِ مَنْ يُتَّهَمُ بِالْكَذِبِ. And in the chain of narration, isn't somebody who is suspected to have lied. وَلَا يَكُونُ الْحَدِيثُ شَاذًا. And the hadith cannot be shadh, meaning it cannot oppose other narrations. وَيُرْوَى مِنْ غَيْرِ وَجْهِ نَحْوِ ذَلِكَ. And it's also narrated from more than one face. Other narrations are present. فَوَعِدَّنَا حَدِيثٌ حَسَنٌ. Then it becomes hadith which is what? It becomes hadith which is Hasan. Ibn Hajar, here right now where we are, what did he define it as? When he defined it, he said, وَالْخَبَرُ الْآحَادُ بِنَقْلِ عَدْلٍ تَامٍ ضَبْتٍ مُتَّصِلُ السَّنِدِ غَيْرَ مُعَلَّلٍ وَلَا شَاذٍ. When he mentioned that which was صحيح لذاتي, that was صحيح لذاتي, after he said, فَإِنْ خَفَّ الضَّبْتُ فَلَحَسَنُ لِذَاتِهِ. When he spoke about after he spoke about tafawut rutbati, and also when he spoke about taqdim al-Bukhari ala al-Muslimi, then he said, فَإِنْ خَفَّ الضَّبْطُ, if the memory slightly deducts and it goes less, he says, فَالْحَسَنُ لِذَاتِي. That hadith is حَسَنُ لِذَاتِي. So if you look at it, it's as though Ibn Hajar rahimahullah, the hadith, حَسَن لِذَاتِي and صَحِيحٌ لِذَاتِي, the difference between the two is what? خفة الضبط. Just a memory. If you look at the definition given by Imam al-Tirmidhi, Imam al-Tirmidhi, his definition is weak in the sense why he's only defined one of the parts of Hasan, which is Hasanul Ghayri. His definition only talks about which one? Hasanul Ghayri. That's what he did. And it was for him to, which one was it that he should have defined? He should have defined Hasanul Lidati, not Hasanul Ligayri, which will come to us. Because the Hasanul Ligayri in its original essence is weak, right? It's weak in its original essence. Because Hasanul Ligayri will come to it later. ارتقى إلى مرتبة الحسن لانجباره بتعدد الطرق. It only became strong because of the support that came to it from other places. Hasanul Ligayri. So, the chosen definition is what? It's as follows. It is, هو ما اتصل سنده. It is any hadith which is chain of narration is connected. بنقل عدل الذي خف ضبطه. With reliable narrators whose memory is slightly deficient. And مثله from the likes of it. Now when we say from the likes of him, it doesn't mean that every single narrator in the chain of narration has to be خفيف الضبط. His memory is low. It means it can be somebody like him, or it can be somebody higher than him. Can't be less. إلى منتهى من غير شذوذ. Until the end of the chain of narration, without any شذوذ in it, or no علّة. What is the ruling on a hadith which is حسن لذاته? What's the ruling regarding it? Huh? The ruling, brothers, is it is كالصحيح في الاحتجاج. When we use it, it's like the صحيح. حسن لذاته is a proof, is a حجة. You can't say, this hadith is... No. Even that in terms of strength, is lower than what? Sahih, right? It's lower than it. But then in terms of implementation, it's obligatory. You have to take it. All the fuqaha relied on it and they used it. The muhaddithun used it. The usuliyun, they used it. Except those who have opposed, who are weak. Huh? Some of the scholars who were mutasahilin, lean scholars in hadith, they added the hasanu lidati. They said that they refer to it as a sahih. Huh. And they put it under sahih. Such as who? Al-Hakim, Ibn Hibban, Ibn Khuzayma. What's an example for a hadith which is hasanun lidatihi? What is the definition, example for it? Example is that which Tirmidhi narrated, rahimahullah. Tirmidhi said, حدثنا قتيبة حدثنا جعفر بن سليمان الضبعي عن عمران الجوني عن أبي بكر بن أبي موسى الأشعري قال سمعت أبي بحضرة العدو يقول قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن أبواب الجنة تحت ظلال السيوف الحديث. This hadith Imam Tirmidhi narrated it. Tirmidhi says, حدثنا قتيبة بن سعيد. قتيبة بن سعيد is the teacher of who? قتيبة بن سعيد is the teacher of Imam Tirmidhi. Tirmidhi said, قتيبة told me that he narrated from Ja'far ibn Sulaiman al-Duba'i. He narrated it from who? Ja'far ibn Sulaiman al-Duba'i. That's who he narrated it from. Who then narrated it from who? Abi Imran al-Jawniyi. So, Ja'far ibn Sulaiman al-Duba'i narrated it from who? أبي عمران الجولي who then narrated it from أبي بكر ابن أبي موسى الأشعري who said I heard. So أبي بكر ابن أبي موسى is the son of the companion أبو موسى الأشعري. It's his son أبو بكر. He said I heard my father meaning أبو موسى الأشعري بحضرة العدو in the presence of the enemy saying that the messenger said إن أبواب الجنة the doors of Jannah are under what? تحت ظلال السيوف. They are under the shades of the swords. Now this hadith is حسن لذاتي. Because Tirmidhi rahimahullah said, هذا حديث حسن غريب. Tirmidhi said, this is a hadith which is حسن and it's غريب. Strange. Okay? And the hadith is حسن. Because لأن رجال إسناده الأربعة ثقات. The four narrators that are in that chain of narration are ثقة, reliable. In their memory they are on top notch. Huh? And in their memory and their reliability is up there. So there's nothing wrong with them. Except in one individual. Whose name is who? Ja'far ibn Sulaiman al-Duba'i. He is حسن الحديث. ما معنى حسن الحديث؟ His memory is slightly low, deficient. As Imam al-Hafiz ibn Hajar mentioned in Tahdhib al-Tahdhib, and he brought this from who? Abi Ahmad.